A2i has impacted our campus so positively. When we had the first training, when Sarah came in to sit down with our team, the teachers left the PD session, and you could hear an audible, I get this now. Now I understand how many minutes. Now I understand how rotations can work. Oh, I can use that resource. I can go here, and instead of teachers spending so much extra minutes on trying to fill the gaps for kids, they actually had a place they could go that was telling them what to do. My name is Amanda Jacobs. I'm the elementary school leader here at Phoenix Collegiate Academy. I've been in education for 10 years. This is my first year as principal of a school. I taught special education for 3 years and elementary education for 6 years. So going into this year, I was really excited to use the experience from special education, elementary education, in order to be able to bring all of that education to the plate and transform our school here. A2i has upgraded the time teachers are spending differentiated, because now teachers aren't spending time just focusing on the students who aren't getting it, but now they're able to actually spend time in making sure all kids are getting what they need, and they're looking at their high performers, their mid performers, and their lower performers in order to make sure all kids are getting what they need. And that was not necessarily happening at the beginning of the year when we were just learning and trying to understand what this literacy block looked like. Currently, Phoenix Collegiate Academy Elementary School is 98% free and reduced lunch, and we have, I believe, 43% ESL, and then in special education, we've got roughly 24% in special education. What I like best about A2i is that research backs up what is in front of teachers and kids, and teachers have a very practical approach to how they're navigating literacy in classrooms. Literacy instruction has changed drastically from the very beginning of the school year to where it is now. The major shift has been more time is spent with kids learning and less time is spent on teachers grappling with what to do. So when we started this fall, we had 8% of our incoming class was at pre-K level when they started. Now we have 88% of our kindergarten at kindergarten level or higher. The average kindergarten student is at 0.9 months. 1.0 would be 10 months or first grade level. So the average student is 1 month away from being first grade, which is really exciting to know that we're on track given where we started the year. It's just great for kids, and it's great for teachers, and it's more output for less input, and that's really what teachers need.